Hello guys, I'm Palak and welcome back to another travel vlog in London. Now this video is ideal for all you people who are in London for a week, and just know that London is not just about central London, Oxford Street, Piccadilly Circus. There's so much more to it than just these places. So yes, this is my one day out guide in London. Now when it comes to London, it's the entire area that is inside the M25. So it's not just central London, and in this video I'll be covering all those places which can be reached from wherever you are staying in about an hour or 2 hours. So just sit back, relax, enjoy, and keep watching my travel vlog. This town on the River Thames in Southeast England is the perfect day out, especially for day trips from London. So here's my guide on how to spend a day in Windsor.
Hello guys, I have Nidhi here with me.
Hi everyone.
Hum dono friends hai since BTech. It's been kitne saal ho gaye yaar?
9 years?
9 years. We have been friends for 9 years, and today we are together exploring the city of Windsor. और हम यहाँ की सबसे छोटी street में खड़े हैं, like an iconic spot for both of us. This is called the Queen Charlotte Street, and हम दोनों आज साथ में विंजर घूमेंगे. Let's just go ahead and explore the Windsor Castle.
Before moving on to the castle, don't forget to check out the famous Crooked House, which is now a jewelry shop in Windsor. It's right beside the Queen Charlotte Street and is hard to miss. Windsor Castle is the oldest and largest occupied castle in the world, and it is this place where last year Prince Harry and Meghan Markle tied the knot. If you plan to visit the castle from inside, don't forget to buy the tickets online well in advance, and also come early in the morning to visit this place. It will save you a lot of time and help you enjoy the city better. After that, we spend some time sitting in the Windsor Park. You can also take the long walk, which is also called the Royal Walk, starting from here till the Snow Hill. After that, we grabbed some lunch at Thai Terrace Kitchen. You can get a lot of things on Thames Street, but don't forget to check out the embedded clock right outside Pizza Express on Thames Street. It's really cool. Next, we had to visit the Windsor Royal Shopping Centre. Situated in the historic Victorian railway station, it's full of shops, restaurants, and vintage details. You can skip this and hop on to a cruise and take a tour of River Thames instead as well. To sum up, Windsor with its beautiful cobble street, heritage architecture, and of course the picturesque River Thames makes this place one of my must-visit places when you are in London.
So Cambridge, where do I even start about Cambridge? It was so beautiful, so serene, so calm, peaceful, full of greenery. I absolutely did not know that Cambridge was so beautiful. When Gaurav said that we want to go to Cambridge, I was like, nah, not my kind of place. I don't want to vlog it. I don't want to do anything about Cambridge. Cambridge is not my kind of place. But you know what guys, it was beautiful. I absolutely enjoyed every bit of my time in Cambridge. Unfortunately, I don't have any vlog for that. Sorry, but I do have pictures that I'll be sharing. They're coming right after my talks. So yeah, Cambridge has to be one of your stops. It's beautiful. And if you are somebody who loves science and who is kind of, you know, nerdy and all, then you have to visit the Trinity College and its library. It was amazing to visit the college and the library and how these big people studied there and invented so much. So yes, pictures coming right in.
Visit the world famous university buildings right here at Cambridge, starting from King's College, Trinity College, and even the Cambridge University. There's a lot to explore. Go punting on River Cam, it's absolutely magical. And last but not the least, just enjoy and soak up into the streets of Cambridge. It's beautiful. The first thing that attracts me the most about Greenwich is its colorful markets. Oh my god, I had such a great time exploring all of its markets. So number one, I explored the vintage market and then we went to the Greenwich market. So there is this narrow street that takes you through and opens up in a very wide arena. Space is filled with so many creativities, you guys. Paintings, handmade products, food. There are so many stalls. You can just spend your time easily out here and you won't even realize that you have spent so much time in the Greenwich market. So yes, I absolutely love the markets. They are a must visit for me. The next stop was the Greenwich Observatory, where the meridian line splits the eastern and western hemisphere into two, just like the equator does for the northern and southern hemisphere. So if you stand with one foot on either side of the line, you are practically in two parts of the world at the same time. Well, in addition to that, you can also enjoy the spectacular views of the London skyline right from top of the hill as well. Spend some time relaxing in the Greenwich Park, which is a huge area and is absolutely worth it. And introducing my friend Rohini here, we had some amazing time with each other, laughing and just posing before we headed to the Royal Naval College. This building was designed by the famous architect Sir Christopher Wren and is one of the most famous buildings and is known for its symmetrical architecture. Number 6 on the list is the Cutty Sark. This is a very old ship and is the only surviving tea clipper which was used to import tea from China. If you have time, then don't forget to check out the library, which has some amazing deals sometimes, so you might just get lucky. Don't forget to check out this shop called Rustic Chick and Postmark for amazing souvenirs and greeting cards. And last but not the least, just drop by to Neha's stall in the vintage market. She has some amazing lip-smacking Indian food. Mujhe to ghar ki yaad aa gayi. So yes, don't forget to check her out as well.
So we have already covered three places. This keeps you sorted for 3 days when you are in London. For remaining 4 days, I'll really encourage you guys to check out Bath and Stonehenge. There are amazing tours, like one day tours that keep happening from London. There are a lot of tourist agencies that do that. I will link them in the description bar below if you want to check out. So it's a nice one day out where you cover both the UNESCO World Heritage sites at once. So check out that. And then for the remaining time, I will really encourage you to check out Brighton, because it's a perfect day out with the beach and you get to relax. You can spend like a night there as well. I have my Brighton vlog as well as a vlog to the city of Bath. I've done it before, so I'll link them somewhere here. Just check it out, because you know guys, if I would put everything in one vlog, it'll be too long, it gets boring. And yes, no visit to London is complete without going to central London. I will do a vlog on it super soon, so stay tuned. So yes, that's all from me guys for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. Do let me know in the comment section below how you like it. I'll see you super soon in my next video. Till then, keep watching and stay happy. Bye-bye.